Bacterial infections can be life-threatening. MRSA, a drug-resistant bacteria, doesn't just occur in healthcare settings. It has become a problem in gyms and locker rooms across the nation. Christopher is an athlete who knows this all too well.
My name is Christopher. I'm a former professional hockey player, so I constantly work out. A few days after hockey practice, my ankle swelled and filled with fluid. I felt a tightness around my ankle, and it was almost like if your sock was a little bit too tight. And that was about 11 o'clock in the morning. By 6 p.m., my ankle was about the size of a grapefruit. I suffered through the tightness of my ankle for the first 2 days. At the end of the second day, I decided to go to the hospital. They did some tests on it. For over a week, the hospital wasn't sure what was causing my problems. The pain was so overbearing that I had to keep my ankle elevated above my heart just to avoid the worst possible pain. The fluid sample from my ankle indicated that I had a MRSA infection. I have no idea how I got it. I had to undergo emergency surgery to drain the infected fluid that was in my ankle. I came out of surgery successful. I was lucky. I'm lucky to be alive.
And Christopher may never know how exactly he contracted MRSA, but back with tips on how to avoid it and what to do if you do get infected is Dr. Frieda Lewis-Hall, the Chief Medical Officer of Pfizer. Welcome back.
Thank you, thank you. Always great to be here. So let's start by saying what MRSA is. And, you know, I tell everybody, brace yourself because it's a mouthful. It's methicillin-resistant Staphylococcus aureus. It's basically a type of staph bacteria. Staph bacteria is very common. And you can find it on your body. If we swabbed the audience today, for example, we would find lots of staph. But it doesn't usually cause infections. Now, MRSA, this strain, does cause infections, and it causes infections of a certain type because it has become resistant to the antibiotics that we usually use when staph does cause infections. So how does it become resistant? Well, some believe that it happens with overuse of antibiotics, like taking them when we don't really need them, or misuse or underuse of antibiotics, like not taking a full course of antibiotics as it's prescribed. And it may start as a very small infection, sometimes even unnoticeable, and then it can spread. And when it spreads, it can affect joints and heart and lungs and brain and many other organs and can be devastating. And as we saw from Christopher, it can spread really quickly.
Figuring out how you get it is one way to potentially prevent it, because one way is through direct contact with an infected wound. Now, MRSA infection risk can also be increased in situations involving skin-to-skin contact, shared supplies or equipment, because again, the bacteria can live on these things.
Now, anyone can get a MRSA infection, but some people are at greater risk. So athletes like Christopher, students, daycare students and school students, military personnel when they live in barracks, and people who have had medical treatment recently. And interestingly, people can mistake a staph or MRSA infection for a spider bite, because it often starts as a little raised bump that can be red. Kind of looks like a bite.
It's always important. Listen to your body. Talk to your doctor if you think something isn't quite right. If the wound does begin to spread, increasing redness spreads, it's painful, warm to the touch, you recognize pus or other drainage. Or the other big thing is if the wound is accompanied by a fever, that's when you know it requires immediate medical attention. We really don't want to scare people, because most skin infections caused by MRSA can still be treated without major complications. But to avoid the spread of MRSA, do cover your wounds with clean, dry bandages until they're healed. And of course, follow your doctor's instructions about proper wound care. Small cuts can become really big problems, particularly if you're immunocompromised or diabetic.
It is critical to wash your hands often. And I know people get told that every day and you hear it all the time, but there's a reason why. Because it is one of the most effective ways to reduce infection, including MRSA. Also, people should remember to bathe and shower regularly, especially after exercise. And this is so critical, don't use other people's personal items like razors, and don't let anybody use yours. You never know what bacteria might be on those items. Make sure that all of your gym and exercise clothing and equipment stays clean. And if you're in spending time in a locker room, make sure you're in flip-flops when you do. So if you think you have a MRSA infection, you should reach out to your doctor right away. If your doctor prescribes an antibiotic, take it as prescribed. It becomes really important to stay in close communication with your healthcare team to make sure they know how well you're responding to that treatment. For more information, you could always go to gethealthystayhealthy.com.
And of course, Christopher, we're so happy you're doing well. Yep. We'll also have a link at our website, thedoctortv.com. We'll be right back.